Hi everyone, Duke of the Bump here. This is more Let's Play Alex Kidd in the Enchanted Castle. This is the splashy sea. Rather than dive into the sea right away though, I'm going to be taking the top route in my pedocopter. This is the route that allows you to touch small children inappropriately. I'm just kidding. That's not really what this is about. Sorry if I got anybody's hopes up. But no, the top route is really all about getting money. Lots and lots of shiny bomb. Since, like I said, I want to try to finish the game with 9,990, every little bit helps. It's not really hard to do. And those are the bombs that I was talking about. So yeah, you lose your copter if you touch the water, if you hit an enemy, if you hit your propeller on something. If you do pretty much anything in the copter except land on solid ground, then you lose it. Okay, and there's an arrow pointing down. You can see the rice cake down there indicating the end of the level. Before we go that way though, we're going to see what lies at the bottom of the sea. It is full of intriguing wildlife. Turtles that launch up and fly through the air. Fish that explode when you punch them. Truly, the ocean is nature's cruelest mistake. So yeah, I forgot to mention in the last video, but this game has one-hit kills. So if anything touches you, you're dead. Makes it pretty challenging, but that's how we did it back in the old school. Aww, the set of blocks is shaped like a heart. Isn't that cute? How endearing. And kawaii. Now, other than Gunstar Heroes, this is really the first Japanese game I've LP'd. Most of the games I play tend to be made by American or English development studios. I'm not too sure about World of Illusion. I did like Crusader, another treasure game, but I didn't make a thread for that, so that doesn't count. But yeah, this game has a surprising number of Japanese references left in for being a game released in America. For example, they still call Rock, Paper, Scissors, Junkin. If you go to the main menu, there's a little sub-game where you can practice, and it's called Junkin. And of course, there's the rice case that are left in. Not sure about the money. It looks vaguely like a sort of bastardized yen symbol. I'm not sure if that's an actual culture's currency or what. Okay, here's a game where we can get the staff, which allows you to walk on air, and it only costs 50 to play this one instead of 500, so I'll go ahead and try this. I think paper always works against him. I'm not entirely sure. Yep. Looks like that worked. One change from the Japanese version of this game is, in the Japanese version, when you lose at Rock, Paper, Scissors, all of your clothes fly off, and it has a strategically placed fig leaf. Or three strategically placed fake leaves if you're playing against a female. But in this one, they just drop a cartoon weight on you, and you grow two big red feet, and you shuffle back and forth. I guess they thought fake leaves were a little too risque for an American audience. And there's another game down here. That's the cape that gives you temporary invulnerability. Think paper works against him too. Oops. So why did I throw scissors? Now see, where do those feet come from? I didn't have big red clown feet before. I guess getting crushed just causes you to grow them. Try this again. Aw, he changed it up on me. Usually if it's a tie, you can throw the same thing and win. I'm not saying that's always the case, but that seems to be the tendency for me. Okay, so now we've seen we've gotten every item. We don't have a motorcycle anymore because I fudged up, but that's everything. And I'll show them off eventually. If I find a place where the skywalking or the invulnerability is useful, then I'll use the item. Because those items go away after you use them, unlike the other ones. Alright, and I suppose that is the end of the Splashy Sea. So, let's move on from here. This is the Scorpion Desert. It's an awful lot of vertical in this level. We can jump up here and... crap. There's a bunch of chests with lots of shiny bomb. Oh, what? Why did I lose altitude there? It doesn't make any sense. Well, I guess this might be an opportunity to use a skywalking cane. And you can sort of hover over. You can't attack while you're in this mode. You can move in any direction. I don't know how long it lasts, though. So, oh, I guess that's how long it lasts. And a little handy trick if you're stuck on top of chests like that is to bring out the pogo stick. You can open them by jumping on them. Okay, I'm not going to risk jumping on that scorpion with the pogo stick because it's unfairly killed me before. Another way to gain height in this level is to use this, but there's not really a whole lot over here. Well, I guess I could use a copter to get up there, but screw it. And we have some antlions, I think is what the game calls them. And some more bombs. Couldn't be anything useful like an extra life, oh no. Not sure what eagles are doing in the desert. I guess they're looking for the Hotel California. I think they have the wrong desert though. This is definitely Egypt. You can tell by the pyramids in the background. Oh, a wise guy, huh? There were two mummies standing there and it looked like one. Gotta be careful with stuff like that. You don't want it to catch you off guard. I'm not sure if I want to bother getting up there. Eh, what the hell. I'll never get tired of this music. Music hath charms to soothe the savage beast. Okay, that's enough of that. And how much you want to bet that green chest is bombs? I'd stake my entire fortune on it. Good thing I don't have a fortune. Wait, it was bombs. That means it doesn't matter if I have a fortune or not. I suppose that's enough for now. Alright, and tune in next time for the Pyramid. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you later.